إن الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. ليس لنا رب سواه، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Just a brother, he mentioned us, please turn off your phone, but still some brothers using the phone. Wallahi, it's disturbing me more than anyone else. نشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we see everything around us today depend on two things: power and money. If you have the power, you are very strong. If you have the money, you are very strong. But if you have both, you really stand firm. You have everything. But none of them can work alone. Power cannot work alone. Money cannot work alone. But you see, the whole world today depends on the power and the money. And the people who has the power depend on the people who has the money. And the people who has the money depend on the people who has the power. But there are different power, more stronger than anything else. You think about it in your life, it's the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the power of the dua. The power of the dua. Not the power of human being or the money. It's the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you believe in that, and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have a faith, then you have everything. The dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he accepts it, can cover everything. When Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said to Allah, لا تجعل على الأرض من الكافرين ديارا إنك إن تذرهم يضلوا عبادك ولا يلدوا إلا فاجرا كفارا. Oh Allah, destroy all of the people. I don't need any one of them, the people who has no iman. Allah, destroy all of them, except the people, the few numbers who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam. When Sayyidina Ayyub getting sick and he make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتُ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Oh Allah, I'm getting sick and you are the merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his dua and he cure him. When Sayyidina Yunus was in the middle of the ocean in the well, no one listened to his dua except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The malaika said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we see stars coming from the middle of the ocean. Ya Allah, he said, no, Abdi Yunus. He said, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. Fastajabna lah. Allah accept his dua right away. And we see all the importance of the dua is very strong. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted us, no one can stop it. But today, we need to understand the most important dua from our father Ibrahim alayhi salam. If Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, the one who is looking for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his faith toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance, talking to his father, talking to his son, talking to his wives. That's Ibrahim alayhi salam. In these days, before we think about the Hajj, we need to understand the importance of the Hajj because of this man, our father, كان حنيفا. And the word of Hanif meaning believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He depends on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you have anything in your life, depend on Allah. This is the faith, the iman. Believe that everything will happen by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a young man, he was looking left and right. Who is Allah? When he looked at the moon and the sun, and we all know the stories, but he depends on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he's talking to his father, and he's telling us what we facing today, disrespect our parents. If we need to correct ourselves, we need to study the seerah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to the whole mankind, the whole Islam in the earth because of Muhammad and his companion sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But the Hajj and the Umrah because of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Do you know how many people landed in Saudi Arabia in the 2023? The number 110 million people. A land that Saudi has it today, it was a desert, no living there. It's just dry. And this number attained only in 1 year because of the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. He was talking to his father with respect. He said, oh father, what you are obeying the son who's not listening to you? لا يسمع ولا يبصر ولا يغني عنك شيء. He's not going to help you at all. Oh father, I got knowledge. Follow me, I will guide you, I will help you. Oh father, don't follow the shaitan. He disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh father, I don't like you to get punished because you follow the shaitan. Then he's talking to his son. He said, أراغب أنت عن آلهتي يا إبراهيم ولئن لم تنتهي لأرجمنك وهجرني مليا. Are you stay away from my idol Ibrahim? Stay away from me all, I will punish you. I throw the stone in you. Respect to his father. He said to his father, سأستغفر لك ربي. I will make استغفار for you. How is it? We don't have that today. Today, our kids argue with each other, with the parents. They don't like the way the parents talking to them. Look at Ibrahim as a young man, how he's talking to his father. قال يا أبتي. Mercy and love. The word come from his mouth. يا أبتي. يا أبتي. Many times he repeated. But when he ignored them, he still continued by the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he ignored them, وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَكُلٌ جَعَلْنَا نَبِيًّا. Because he obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and because of his dua, Allah gave all the prophets from him. From Ishaq alayhi salam, all the prophets, and from Ismail alayhi salam, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Islam in the earth, because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, and the Hajj and Umrah, and the follow by Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, we mention his name all the time in our salawat, and every time when you do it, the tashahud, you are mentioning the name of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was talking to his father. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ. He spoke to his father, his tribe. What you are obeying? They said asnam, idols. وَنَظَلُّ لَهَا عَكِفِينَ forever. And he said to them, هَلْ يَسْمَعُونَكُمْ إِسْتَدْعُونَ. If you make dua and talk, they listen to you. أَوْ يَنْفَعُونَكُمْ أَوْ يَضُرُّونَ. They can benefit you or harm you. They said, no, just to find our parents, just to follow that. قالوا بلى قد وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون. They just doing that. So we follow what they did. So they don't think. But Ibrahim, he was thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said to them, look what you are, obey you and your parents and your grandparents and whatever it is. They are my enemy. فَإِنَّهُمْ عَدُوٌ لِي except إِلَّا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Who is رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. الَّذِي خَلَقَنِي فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ. The one who created me, he is the one who can guide me, Allah. وَالَّذِي هُوَ يُطْعِمُنِي وَيَسْقِينَ. The one who give me the food and the water, he is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the rain come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his order to the earth. You get the plant, you eat, and the water is there because of the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. And if I get sick, he's the only one can cure me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِي يُمِيتُنِي ثُمَّ يُحْيِينَ. Now he realized the one who take the soul and turn it life is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he was testing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. That's Ibrahim alayhi salam. So he depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Then he said, وَقَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. So all his life is dua. Go depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who will guide me. Rabbi habli min as-salihin. Oh Allah, give me from the righteous. He's getting old. He needs a son to carry the message as an old man. And his wife, she's with him all the time. Listen to our kids today. Not even 1 year together, they're looking to get divorced because they don't like each other. Because they're not modern. Look at Ibrahim alayhi salam while he's rich and very old man. Never get one word against his wife, Sarah. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide him moving from one place to another place, until Egypt, until Hajar. And from Hajar alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide him by his dua, accept his dua. رَبِّي هَبْلِي مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Allah guide him by Ismail alayhi salam. Not only that, Allah keep testing him, because ya Ibrahim, all your dua has been accepted all the time. I'm give you test more and more and more. What do you, Ibrahim, think about it? When Allah give him Ismail, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. Now he's got a big man and righteous and huge, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to sacrifice him. But look again at the message between now the father and his son. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ. Oh, my son. Not you. Not the way we're talking to our kids today. Now what yelling at them. Dialogue is حوارٌ between a father and son. يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكْ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. What do you think, يَا إِسْمَعِيل? I saw my dreams that I have sacrificed you. قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ افْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Whatever Allah guide you, go ahead and do it. I will have sabr. Don't worry, your father, go ahead. فلما أسلم وتلاه للجبين وناديناه أي يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا. When he turned his face down and he start put the knife in his son, Allah stopped him. Allah sent Jibreel عليه السلام. Tell him this was a test from Allah تعالى. إن كذلك المحسنين إن هذا لهو البلاء المبين. It was a test from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وفديناه بذبح عظيم. We save him by a sheep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the sheep to him to save his life. Now, when we all prepared for the Qurbani time, the most important question come to all of us today, again, in the beginning, as I said, is the money. Money and power. Money. Asking, where I can slaughter my sheep? I want to do my Qurbani. In this country is more than this country, and here is it cheaper, and there is it cheaper, and why we pay more over there? It depends on your capacity. Understand all the countries is different. You have to count it. The population of the country, the farms and the country, agricultures, if they import the food for the animal or they have it, and how size of the animal is all, most of the Muslim people get in really, really crisis. They have a lot of poor. It doesn't matter where is country you're going to give and how much you're going to give. Don't think about the money. Think about you feed your poor person on the earth, your brother and your sister, no matter where is it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Holy Quran, لَنْ يَنَالُ اللَّهَ لُحُومَهَا وَلَا دِمَئِهَا. Allah will never take this flesh or the blood. But He need the taqwa, He need your iman, how you believe, because you feed your Muslim brothers. Some countries, they have corrupted governments. They like to see their people dying, not to get a piece of meat. They like to see them struggling so they don't attack them. You, as a brother, look at the price here. Last year, the cow cost over 4,500. And some country, Muslim countries, much, much less. Why wouldn't count it this way? My response is, you can go to your own country with different flights, same distance, and you pay less from the different prices from different company. Count it the same thing. The price in different country doesn't matter for us. For us as a believers, we need to give some meat for our Muslim brothers who cannot afford it. As a Muslims, alhamdulillah, Allah guide us in this earth to help each others. That's what Ibrahim alayhi salam, his dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the order to leave his son and his wife in a place with no water, no agriculture, nothing. He said to Allah, I left my wife and my son. بِوَادٍ غَيْرَ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Oh Allah, I left them in the desert. Nothing with them. They have no water, no food. But he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. رَبَّنَا وَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. Oh Allah, let some people come over there and help them. Allah provide them by the people coming from Yemen. They speak the Arabic language. Ismail alayhi salam learned the language. And they have agreement together. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide them by the water of Zamzam. Allah help them because of the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. With no water, no agriculture, nothing. Today is a very wealthy because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the dua of Ibrahim when he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَرْزُقْهُمْ. Give them the rizq, ya Allah. Allah accepted. What about us today? How we got closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? One person who is asking a very wealthy man, and he said to him, I study hard. I was number one in my college. I have a lot of projects, but I cannot find a job. While people less experienced than me, they have job because they know they have a connection. So the wealthy man respond back to him with a smiling, and he say to him, by the way, they're non-Muslim, both of them non-Muslim. And he say to him, you miss the most important thing. It's not the study, it's not anything else, it's not the connection. Did you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Did you raise your hand and ask your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I did so and so, and ya Allah, I lift it for you? It take me direct to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. قَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. Allah, He will guide me. So he missed the most important thing. He need the response from the wealthy man, say, I give you a job. He said, no, go and pray. Tell your Lord, talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I did everything, now it's your turn, Ya Allah, to help me out. Did you do that? Now as a Muslims, alhamdulillah, we pray 5 times a day. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The power, the people use it and their money against the Muslim people is not going to survive. The Islam will be remained. This is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when we talk about the power and the money, the whole world is against a few number of people in Gaza. And they're still surviving. They're still fighting back. Because of what? Listen what they said when they sent the missiles. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. Inna Allah qad rama. Allah is the one who threw it, not us. So they depend on Allah. The dua Allah accepted from them. Many countries against them, including the Muslims countries. But this group of people is still surviving by the dua. So the importance of the dua, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah give it to us as a believers. Advice to the parents, never ever make dua against your children, no matter what. No matter how much mistakes they are doing. Please accept it. Talk to them. Because if you make dua and the sky is open and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it, they will never survive in the dunya. Remember two things. In Laylatul Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the malaika to witness the people who pray and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then they return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by all the good news as the people who pray and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر. الملائكة has come and then they go. But the day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come to the سماء الدنيا الأولى and he's witness all of the people in the earth, mainly in the people in the Arafat and the people who's fasting with them and the people who's making dua. Then he's talking to his malaika, look at my servant, they come because he loved me and I love them. Oh malaikati, be my witness, I forgive all of the sins. All the sins the people do and they go one time in the Arafat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make completely remove the whole sins because of the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Sacrificing is a lot to talk about it. If you are sick, slaughter something, small or big. If you got cure, slaughter, sacrifice something. It's for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This blood can cure a lot of things. If you have difficulty in your job, do it if you have the ability. If you have a good job, do it. Feed the poor and need. Allah love it. Allah love the blood to come from the animal. We say, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. It's for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us to choose the best for the poor and need, insha Rabb al-Alameen. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma shfi mardana wa marda al-Muslimin. Irham amwatana wa amwat al-Muslimin. La taj'al lana dhanban illa ghafarta. Wala maridan illa shafaita. Wala mayitan illa rahimta. Allahumma aghfir liwalidina wa rahamhuma kama rabbayana sighara. Allahumma ab'ad ash-shaytan an biyutina wa an abnaina wa ummahatina wa azwajina ya kareem. Ya Rahman ya Rahim. Nas'alaka sharbatan ma'in min yadi rasulika al-kareem. La nadhma abada. Allahumma askinna jannatan جنات النعيم. اللهم أرينا آبانا إبراهيم ومحمد وأصحابي أجمعين. اللهم ارزقنا شربة ماء لا نظمى بعدها أبدا ندخل بها جناتك جنات النعيم. يا رحمن يا رحيم حرم النار على أجسادنا. اللهم حرم النار على أجسادنا. اجعل آخر كلماتنا في هذه الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. لا تقبض أرواحنا يا ربنا إلا وأنت راض عنا يا كريم. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.